of the day, Dr. T.P. Shashikumar, space scientist and renowned life mentor. Thank you all for being a part of this Jubilant celebrations. I assure you, our students will win your hearts. Yesterday, same time, same place, witness the inaugural day of our annual day celebrations. Dr. Mala Reddy Perati, Professor, Department of Mathematics and Principal, College of Engineering and Technology, Kakatiya University, grace the occasion in the capacity of chief guest, and our skilled students rock the stage. Let's give a start to the Navakala Mahotsav of Navbharat Schools.
Oh, ya kundendu tushara hara dhavala, ya shubhra vastrandita, ya veela varadanda manditakara, ya shweta padmasana, ya brahma chuta Shankara Prabhudilih Devai Sada Pujita Sammam Patu Saraswati Bhagavati Nissesha Yadya Paha
Ramadas Kirtana, Anta Ramamayam, Varani Ragam, Aditalam.
Anta Ramamayam, Bijagam, Anta Ramamayam. Anta Ramamayam, Bijagam, Anta Ramamayam.
In flowers. So dear dignitaries, we present our smiles to you in the form of bouquets. Firstly, joyously moving forward is Tanvi of UKG and Snigdha to offer a bouquet to the chief guest of the day, Dr. T.P. Shashikumar, space scientist and life mentor, renowned life mentor. Your presence has illuminated the ambience, dear sir. Let's give him a big round of applause. Dr. Shashikumar was a space scientist for nearly two decades in government service. In 2009, he took voluntary retirement and opted to be a motivational speaker and a life mentor. Dr. Shashikumar has a profound passion for reaching students and teachers and motivating them. He reached over 600,000 teachers and 1 million students through his lectures and various venues. Dr. Shashikumar elaborates life. Please note, he elaborates life as learning is an investment for future learning, and that learning leads to full enjoyment. He believes in physical, emotional, intellectual, social and spiritual balanced life. Sir, we draw a lot of inspiration from you. Your presence is a great asset for the students and teachers. Thank you, sir. Kritika of UKG and Harshita.
T.P. Shashikumar, space scientist and life mentor. My beloved students, I would like to extend my warm greetings to you all on the occasion of the 41st annual day celebrations of Navbharat Schools, which is aptly titled as the Navakala Mahotsav. Ladies and gentlemen, the stage of today's valedictory function of NBS has been enhanced many folds with the presence of our chief guest, Dr. Shashikumar. He is a multifaceted personality with varied skills. He is a great motivator and mentor. Dr. TPS, as he is fondly known as, worked as a scientist in the space department for two decades. He served as director at the Academic Staff College at the UGC at the University of Calicut, and also served as a deputy director at the Directorate General of Security, Cabinet Secretary, New Delhi, before taking voluntary retirement in 2009. For a brief period, he served as management professor in an engineering college at J2H. He was executive director of an engineering college in Kerala for 1 year. Dr. TPS established Gnanam, a hermitage, to run short-term housing essential camps for youth, in which youth from 20 countries participated between 2014 and 18. He authored books like Life But Simple, Life of Love, Rhythm of Life, Life is to Live, Life Reflections, etc. Now he feels fortunate to have a life mentor of this nature as chief guest in its valedictory function. Our students would draw a great deal of inspiration with your presence, sir.
Words shape humanity. Words give motivation to move on. Words of experienced and eminent personalities become a treasure. Amongst us, in the capacity of chief guest, is Dr. Shashikumar, space scientist, a renowned motivational speaker and life mentor. Let's welcome him with a thunderous applause to share his virtues and motivate our students. Dr. Shashikumar.
Namaskaram. When somebody says Namaskaram, responding back with Namaskaram is Bharatiya Samskaram. Yes or no? Namaskaram. Namaskaram. That's great. I remember your principal Reddy Garu called me and said you should come for this annual day program. I said, but most boring thing in my life is going for annual day programs, I said. Because generally, it's a program of children demonstrating their activities. So in between, some old fellows comes. The audience will say, Mahapapi, get out of this place, right? I don't want that shaba in my life. So though I must have gone to thousands of academic institutions, I avoid these programs. But immediately there is another Srinivas Rao, a great man who is with Muhammad Ali, the fireman.
Muhammad Ali is a great fireman, right? Yeah.
He was behind me for a few days after, unfortunately, I came into Enadu paper, and he was behind me. He said, I am also from the same place, you should come. So I am here just because of him. And he is here just because of these two people who are the management representatives. But that's all not good. Audience for longer discussions or talk is not new to me in my life. Because when he asked, he said, you can take 20 minutes, but your management said you can take more time also. But I am not happy with that. I have a great colleague of mine sitting here in front of me, Ayala. He paid me for 2 years. My government salary was my account officer. He signed my salary. It's great to see somebody who is my colleague. I'm sure he must have never expected that a colleague of him, where we used to sit in meetings, right, sir? You never thought I will be here, because generally somebody gets into government, they die in government or retire useless. But I decided to come out of government not becoming that useless. I found that I was useless. I was useless and I had to become useful somewhere else. So I left government, said tata bye to Manmohan Singh. I was with Manmohan Singh's office. I was with the PM's office. So I thought, no, that's not my place. My place is people. Immediately, I came to Kerala, to a small place. Took 90 worst children in that area, probably the worst in Kerala, 10 years back. And that's what attracts me to CSR projects. Corporate Social Responsibility Project. One rich man was sponsoring the program. And today, when after 10 years I look back to those children, they are into international standard, the best of the best in the world. Somebody is in Germany doing PhD. Many of them are under fellowship doing master's program, M.Tech in different colleges, 17 of them in Bangalore city with employment. So I'm sure that if you want to make difference and change in life, they need only good mentor. If you have got good directions given, people can be different. I am here today when the school is generating our 41st anniversary, right? I remember 15 years back I wrote an article when I was 40 years old in a good magazine in India. The magazine name itself was 40 plus. Because I know most of the people who are 40 plus, especially ladies, they understand the problems in life. The problems in life starts when they cross 40. Physically they will become dull. Emotionally they become totally confused because their children would have been 15 years old. Teenage. Having a teenage as a child is the biggest challenge. Difficult challenge in life. What did he say? She is giving me hints. What did he say?
It's a challenge.
Yeah, it's a challenge. And both parents will be fully panic. Most of the people who contact me for psychological counseling are not children, the 40 plus. Because they don't know what to do with this child. Nothing wrong, nothing bad. Because I am talking to you from a place which is called... Who is that? What is famous for this place? Or why this place is famous? The first song he was here was Taraka Rama song, right? You know, there is a great psychology book in this country. The psychology started with the teenage problem of Rama. Do you know who is Rama, that Rama? Sita's husband. Later he became Sita's husband. But the teenage problem after plus one, plus two academic education, I don't know which, Navabharat or Old Bharat. Some Bharat, he was educated by a great guru. When he came out of the school, his father's name was Bharat. He was never giving respect. I remember some of the talk here was, during this time children won't listen to. That same thing happened to Lord Rama also. He was never listening. And when somebody asked who is the worst fellow in the world, he used to say, my father who is the king you. That happens to all parents. The teenage children will say, my parent is not good. It happened to that. Immediately, the king sent this Rama to a psychotherapist. He was Dr. Vasishtha. You must have heard. Vasishtha. And 18 days of training changed Rama into a good Rama. Otherwise, he was not that good Rama. So who changed Rama is Dr. Vasishtan, and the book written is called Yoga Vasishtha. Though I have got a degree of Master of Science in Psychology, I read all the Western philosophical methods of treating people, I still follow Yoga Vasishtha. Purne manasi sampurnam jagat sarvam sudhatravaihi upana gudapadasya nanucha mastruta eva bubuhu. I'm sure you did not understand anything. Nothing wrong. We are in Bharat. We don't understand Sanskrit. Nothing wrong with that. Yeah. And this place is the place where such forms of psychological treatment, India's best place, we heard, it's all Andhra Pradesh. The best place where good literature was written. Lot of dance, music, art forms have developed. And I'm very, very happy to listen. Multiple people who spoke here have taken that. And I was writing most important presence of mind, personality development, leadership, the creativity and all has to be there. All of them spoke the same thing. I only have to speak again. But I remember one of them mentioned Shraddhavan Labhate Jnanam. This is what Krishna told Arjuna. When Arjuna taught many things, Arjuna said, I am not able to follow you because any problem in front of you, a student will not be able to follow anything. He has got a huge number of army people standing there to fight. Where is the Bhagavad Gita class which happens? Even God comes and teaches, he won't understand anything. Before examination, whatever you teach the teachers, students will not understand. Same thing happened to Arjuna also. And then Krishna says, Sraddhavan labhate jnanam. If you have Sraddha, concentration, you will be able to listen to me. But I don't know. We have just given prize to 100% attendance teachers. What is attendance? Is it physical attendance? What is it? It is 100% attentive in the class. How many children in any academic institution becomes 100% attentive in the class? It's very, very rare. I have seen all of them who come to me with the problems of academics problem or job related problems or life problems. One main problem with us, sir, concentration ledhu, sir. Every birth is a problem. I only ask them one question. Do you go for movies? Yes or no? Is there anyone in the cinema theater who says, I am not able to concentrate in the movie? But in classroom, what happens? No attendance. You are not able to attend. Why? You know why? Because most of the teachers keep begging in the class, please listen to me, please listen to me. I call teachers are beggars. They keep on begging, attention please, as if they are great people where you have to attend to them, right? Why the begging is required when somebody has to give knowledge? That's because most of the knowledge which we give today are found to be useless. We don't know where is it used. I could see teachers who say, this is why you are learning this. Give an objective and scope. If objective and scope is not given, the learning becomes useless. Because we always ask a question, why? Why should I learn this? Then only one answer we can give. If you get good marks in 10th, you can go to 11th and 12th in the best college. So what? If you go to best schools in the college, the world, you will become very good. Do you think if you get good marks, you will become great in the world? Yes or no? I am a person who was thrown out of a school being the worst student. I have seen a lot of children enjoying when they are getting awards and rewards. I feel jealous of them because in my life, during my school days, I never got a chance to come onto stage and receive a single prize. Neither in sports, nor in arts, nor in literature, nor in academics. But I used to participate in everything. I used to participate in everything and then fail in most of the times. And in 8th grade, the principal called me and gave a cover. I thought some prize for being some. Then when I opened, I saw transfer certificate, get out of the school. I said, bye-bye, thank you. But same school I went recently to teach teachers in that school. So I'll tell you, don't ever see a student is not academically great, not great in sports, not great in arts and literature, is a bad student. They could become good. Only thing, somewhere they need a spark. And who can give that spark? And that spark can be given only by acharyas, not by teachers, not by gurus. Yadyada acharya nishrestha, tatta devetarochana sayat pramanam kurute, logastha danuvartate. Arjuna was not a great student. But Arjuna at the end said, I trust you. You tell me what should I do, I will do it. So that trust is what is required. If a teacher in your class, somewhere in your life can make that spark in somebody, I'm sure that's a great encouragement. I look forward for such teachers, and they are the teachers who really created or getting created leaders in this world. Education is not writing answers as the teacher teaches and then evaluating. It's all about creativity. I'm sure Pradeep is nodding head and agreeing with that, right? And that happens only when you have education. Who is the goddess for education in Bharatiya Shastram?
Goddess Saraswati.
Who is her husband? Yeah, she has doubt. You only remember. That is why when the prize is given, I said to that lady who got 100%, the husband has to receive. You should also respect your husband sometime. then you will remember the name. It is Brahma. The goddess Saraswati, that is good education is in you only when you keep husband along with you. The husband is Brahma. Brahma's job is creativity. You have to be creative in life. The creativity is do something new, do research. If you don't use your knowledge for getting some extra knowledge, your Saraswati will diverge and go. She will not stay inside you. The Saraswati will not come to your tongue if the brain is creative, and then it automatically will come. So if you want husband inside you, wife has to be there. If wife is inside you, husband has to be there. He is a great investor. Correct, Pradeep? And that is why he is able to give prizes in his father's name, my dear. I am sure the Lakshmi Devi, the Mani Devi is with him only when he is active. That is why Vishnu stays with the Lakshmi. If you are inactive, you don't do karma, then money will not be with you. So dhanam comes only when karma is with you. Karma, knowledge, everything is related. That's why Sraddhavan Lapate Jnanam. Jnana Karma Sanyasa Yoga. Fourth chapter in Bhagavad Gita. I was so fortunate to be in America last few months and then finished my Bhagavad Gita teaching 18 chapters. Stanza by stanza, line by line. It's a great opportunity to understand. Don't read and finish. Don't chant and finish. Don't read library books and finish. I'm so glad that he brought up that idea. I remember when I went to college, one of the engineering colleges, I was taking stock of how much is the crowd in the library. He said, 150%, sir. Everybody comes 3-4 times. You know, in engineering colleges, they go in pair. That's a nice place to hide. Then I asked, how much percentage is the canteen? Sir, that's also 150%. But in the classroom, sir, 25%. See, why a library is not used? Next year, when you celebrate 42nd, give one more prize to your children who write reviews of the best books from the library. See, that should be the encouragement. Ask them to read a book, write a review. If that is written, it is not just reading book. Every competitive exam in this country has got a test on English comprehension. Most of the students fail. You know how many people write? The largest examination in the world is civil service examination. 20 lakhs people register. Only 15 lakhs people write. 5 of them will not go to exam hall because fear of exam. They will say, next year I will write. Because not too many chances are given. And out of that 5 lakhs passes, no, 20,000 people pass. And out of the 20,000, 1,500, 1,200, 1,700, depends on the vacancy, depends on the merit, people get selected. Can you imagine? From 15 lakhs to 1,500. Nowhere in the world is such exam. Where people fail? Most of the time, logical reasoning, power of understanding the subject logically. That's most important. English comprehension. We learn a language, our mother tongue, when we are a young child from 1 year to 2 years or 3 years. Don't we learn our mother tongue in 1 or 2 years in childhood? But I have seen most of the people when they grow up, they cannot learn one language, English, which can be commonly used with a good vocabulary in their life. Why? Because we find it is only an academic exercise, but not a practical life language learning exercise. We have to rethink. If you want to stand in the world and then speak, I'm sure you should do this. You know, we have a great member of parliament from Kerala, Shashi Tharoor. Somebody asked him, how many books you read in a year? He said, how many days are there in a year? That many books I will finish reading. 365 days, every day one book he reads. I remember gifting my books on a program. Before the program is over, he returned back the book I finished, he said. We have not seen such great readers. And that's why he is being taught, he is being discussed in the television in great countries like Britain or in America where English is used. Because English or his English is much better than probably British English or American English. So I'm sure we can improve ourselves. And what I can give in this only few words, I don't know whether I finished my 20 minutes or not, but then I have got few books which is not written by me, written by my student. This is Civil Service Handbook. This is my book on Life Made Simple. This is, many people say, don't discuss anything on social media, don't use telephone, don't see TV, don't go to movie theater. No, I keep saying do all this. But don't forget your main aim in life, that's learning. And this is one which I wrote with the discussions from my students on ORCID. This is on life, Life Made Simple. Few more books, I couldn't get it from my home today. This is a beautiful book on rhythm of life. I was just showing Ali one of the poetry which I wrote when Kalam left us. The poetry name is Malak to Kalam, the Malak. If you write Kalam the reverse way, it is called Malak. K-A-L-A-M, it becomes M-A-L-A-K. Malak means ornaments in Muhammad Ali's Arabic language, which says ornaments. So I say my ornaments to Kalam, who is the real Malak. Malak is the princess, or maybe the heavenly given gift. So Malak was a gift given to us, and that gift is Kalam. So I'm sure I will send a few more books, or maybe you can download it from internet. But this is my gift to this school. I wish somebody reads it sometime. So I've got many more points. I kept writing so many things. My congratulations to all the prize winners. But the prize winners will come and stand here and receive. But I'm sure there are a lot of people who are clapping. They are much more important. Let me hear a big clap in your... No, not enough. Louder. Louder. Stop. No, not good. I thought this area people are so energetic and we'll have a great clap and all that. Nothing is there. Because you know we are used less. Though we can use our energy with the full energy to clap. That's it. Let us do for some namke vaste. Don't do that. Anything which you do, if a parent is not very energetic and active, I'm sure that children will never pick up. If you want your child to be active, what should be done? Parents should be active. I remember in one of the schools when I was a guest some time back, I told, don't have any competition for children. Make the parents to come onto stage and then give all the competitions. Drama competition, dance competition, everything has to be for parents. And it happened, and I witnessed that. I remember when parents are pushing the kids, go and dance, don't make mistakes. When you are an allocution, don't make mistakes. Now I saw the other child is telling the parent, don't make me sad. You perform well, Papa, you have to, otherwise, shame for me, you know. I think it should change, the world has to change. Then if such things happen, and then awards are given to parents, I'm sure next generation children will become good. Otherwise, it doesn't happen that way. I keep saying, every child wants their parents not to scold them for getting less marks. Everything what you learn in the classroom, go and teach your parents. After that, soon after your exam, give the same question paper to your parents and ask them to write exam. Then they will say, beta, good enough. What marks you get, that's the best mark in the world. Right? There are small tricks which you have to learn in life to become very good. Jnana, Karma, Sannyasa Yoga. I heard she was repeatedly asking, it is meditation, clap, clap. Meditation doesn't clap. Meditation is Samadhi. Samadhi is dead. I am a meditation master from Himalayas. Swami Rama is my guru. We don't say, for one purpose you have to close your eyes and do it. Our meditation is not closing eyes and crossing legs. Our meditation is meditation in action. Whatever you do, you should be in meditative process. Put me an electroencephalograph to check my brain is working or not. It has been done in different stages. And I found that I am not using my brain. Because doctor said this brain is not vibrating. Then I said, if buddhi is there, it will work. Buddhi is not there, what will work? What will work? Buddhi is not there, heart will work. So do you have good heart? Yes or no? But your teachers will say, don't learn by heart, don't learn by heart, don't learn by heart. Tell them, ask to translate that into your mother tongue. What do you say? Don't learn by heart in mother tongue? Okay, if it is not there, I will tell you. How is it told in the other way? Learn by heart. Don't learn by heart, but learn by heart. Heart is where you keep the most attractive things in your life. Anything which you learn, you should enjoy. That's why L-I-F-E, life is learn in full enjoyment. If you don't enjoy learning, learning becomes difficult, hard. No, learning should never become hard. It's just simply an exercise of enjoyment. That should happen. Therefore, every teacher should teach not using their brain, but using their manas. Using their heart, it becomes effective, E-effective, and A-effective. It becomes effective and effective. I'm sure then your children will learn knowledge. Though they may not get to 100% in marks, but they will be 100% in knowledge. That is what is essential to win this world. Let your children be physically smart, emotionally controlled, intellectually sharp, socially active, and spiritually higher. Spiritually higher is yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. Every action which they do will come from the manas. Bhagavad Gita, center of the sloka says, Uddharet atmanatmanam, atmanam apasathayet, atmaiva hyatmanavabandhu, atmaiva ripuratmanaha. Read the interpretation from somewhere. Otherwise, go to www.drtps-shiksha.in. Otherwise, type DRTPS, that's my name. Doctor TPS, Thermal Power Station, TPS. Correct, understood? TPS, Thermal Power Station. Doctor TPS, and then Bhagavad Gita. So you will get my YouTube lectures on Bhagavad Gita. Listen to that, you will understand. Uddharet atmanatmanam. Raise your manas and the buddhi which conflicts to the atma level. That is what is called atmiyata. That is called spirituality. We are in a land of full of spirituality. Himalayam samarabhya yavat hindu sarovaram tam deva nirmidam desham hindustanam prajakshati. We are so lucky to be part of this world where we have everything surrendering to God. Every action which we do, I surrender this opportunity given to me by the management, by the principal, for the CSR, but more than that, all the teachers representative here and all the students representative here and all the parents here for giving me this opportunity. I wish I am here many more times. If I would have missed this chance, it would have been a great loss in my life. So I am sure now onwards, no annual day program I will skip. Until I get a bad audience, I am not able to stop because I am seeing your eyes and ears to me with a full manas. But I am sure their hypertension will be up, which I don't want. And she is holding the vent, this fellow will be out. So thank you, thanks a lot, God bless you. Enjoy your life. Most important, enjoy your life. If you don't enjoy your life, your children will say, life is going on like this, jaragutayire. In our language, in Malayala, pogu ipadiye, pogu the Tamil. And you say in Kannada, nadi thayide. In Tamil, I say ijare. No. In Hindi, they will never say. In Gujarat and Bangla, if they say, maje meche, they will say, badu vache. I'm enjoying, enjoying. But when you come to South, people are confused in enjoyment. Because the map itself, my guru says, the map itself says people have to be confused. They are widespread. That's why they are more of godly and we are asuras. The South Indian people are asuras. We don't enjoy. How is life going on like this? And most entertainment is going to hospital. Because we will see a lot of people with the problems. Oh, I am better than them. So I am happier. That's the biggest problem. Don't ever do that. I'll tell you, don't go to doctors for any small purposes. I don't know whether you mentioned it today in the lunch during the discussion, right? Vaidya Raja Namastubhyam. Oh, doctor, salutation to you. Yama Raja Sahodara. You are the brother of Yama. Vaidya Haradume Pranan. Yama Haradume Pranan. Yama will take your life. Vaidyan What he will do? Dhana Anija. He will also give a bill after death. Luckily, I am not telling my age. So far, my weight is 60 kilo today also. For last 25 to 30 years, my weight is 60 kg. As strong as going on like this. So as long as I live, I will be with the people where some change in somebody's life, somewhere, sometime can change. I am sure that is the greatest Deva Pooja. ఏన కేన ప్రకారేణ యస్య కస్యాపి దేహినః సంతోషం జనయత్ ప్రజ్ఞ తదేవ మూషర పూజనం. ఐఎమ్ షూర్ ఇన్ దిస్ స్మాల్ టైమ్ విచ్ ఐ స్పెండ్ విత్ యూ హెస్ మేడ్ సమ్ స్పార్క్ ఇన్ యువర్ లైఫ్ టు ఎన్కరేజ్ యువర్ చిల్డ్రన్ టు బి మోర్ యాక్టివ్ అండ్ స్పోర్టివ్ ఇన్ దర్ లైఫ్ అండ్ దట్స్ ద గ్రేటెస్ట్ బ్లెస్సింగ్ విచ్ ఐ విల్ గెట్ ఫ్రమ్ యూ. గాడ్ బ్లెస్ యూ. థ్యాంక్ యూ. బై బై. ఇఫ్ ఎనీ వన్ ఆఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు కాంటాక్ట్ మీ 944-7437-948 otherwise go and Google Dr. TPS, you will get my number and guaranteed you will get a reply if BSNL is functioning. I don't know when government is going to sell that also. Airline is already in the plan of selling. I'm sure private organizations like people like rich people like these have to buy government organizations and start running. So Navbharati is doing a great thing. Let this become at 41st also, not 40 plus, start Navanava Bharat. Let that be the new name given to this. God bless you. Enjoy talking to you. Salutations.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. We saw
a great
life
ఇక్కడ Yes? See, he knowingly put the wire. So, but I am not going to let it. When somebody gave a gift like this, I said, don't give me like this, give some useful items. Because the rotary club, lion club, which you got, so they are not connected. That's a useful one. Next time they give me an iron box, he said, this is not your business, go and do this job.
So thank you so much again. You are very, very busy and your work really touched our hearts. Thank you once again, sir.
Iron box somewhere people might be having. Better to give something.
Humble request to the chief guest of the day, Dr. Shashi Kumar, to kindly give away this prestigious awards to the students. May I also make a humble request to Mr. Praveen, alumnus of Navbharat School, to please come onto the dais. He is a young entrepreneur. He is the son of our beloved Sri Poonachandra Garu, former Executive Vice President, Navbharat Ventures Limited. So in his memory, he has instituted the YPR Excellence Awards. Every year, these awards are given. And this year, Mr. Pratim has instituted two gold medals, a big round of applause to their thought. Two gold medals to the best two students of Class 10 in academics and best all-rounders. So this is the first year we are going to give away the gold medal, YPR Excellence Gold Medal Awards to the students. And in academics, the student who is going to receive the first YPR gold medal is Kumaridi Lakshmi Sri Shravya, the topper of last year's class 10th examination, who secured 490 marks out of 500 in CBSE examination. She is now pursuing her class 11th intermediate. She was here yesterday to receive her mentor on behalf of management. Now the parents are here to receive the gold medal. A big round of applause for the first YPR gold medal. Now I call upon Kumari K. Anusha, who is going to receive the YPR Excellence Gold Medal for the Best Student Award. She was in class 10, the school head girl too. She is going to receive the gold medal. She is not available right now. Father and sister has come. They have come to receive on behalf of K. Anusha. They are pursuing their exams today, so they could not make it. They are receiving the YPR Excellent Gold Medal Awards. Now let's move to the YPR Excellence Awards to the remarkable achievers for this academic year. I call upon N. Kundana Reddy of Class 10C, CBSE nationalist who went for the 100 meters in nationals held in Raipur, Chhattisgarh. She also bagged the gold medal in the CBSE meet. She is the head girl of the school, the CCA champion too, for the past 9 years. P. Lasipriya of class 10, the CBSE nationalist who also went to Raipur, Chhattisgarh and participated in 1500 meters run in under 19 category. A big round of applause for her. A lot of hard work they have done and reached the nationals. They are receiving the YPR Excellence Awards. B. Arvind Kumar of class 9, who went for the football nationals and sub-junior open nationals held in Bangalore. He represented the Telangana football team. Now here comes M. Kundana Reddy of class 10 for bagging silver and bronze medal in the CBSE Cluster 7 athletics meet in 4 into 100 meters and 4 into 400 meters relay. this 400 meters and doing 400 meters relay where the bag is silver and bronze. B. Vinati. CH Venu Varshitar, class 10, silver and bronze medalist in the two relays, 100 and 400 relays and CBSE cluster 7 athletic meet held in Hyderabad. Pilasi Priya of class 10, yet another team member in this relay team, winning the silver and bronze medal in the 4 into 100 meters and 4 by 400 meters relay. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we should be clapping for them. They have been working very hard on the ground and now they are enjoying their proud moment. N. Prabalika of class 9, a team member of the relay team which won the silver and bronze in the relay, two relay races in the CBSE class 7 athletic meet held in Hyderabad. Of class 9. She represented the school in the CBSE Science Nationals held in Gurugram, Delhi this month. S. Mahesri. They won in the regional level and they were selected for the nationals and they presented the exhibit named Decora, Environment Friendly One. Megasri is receiving her Remarkable Achievers YPR Excellence Award. And I call upon B. Bhavyasri, another team member, she's from 8th class, who went along with Megasri to the CBSE National Science Fair. Scientific minds taking the name of Mount Bharat in the corners of India. I next call upon M. Kundana Reddy of 10th C. She bagged the 16th national rank in the International Unified English Olympiad. A big round for applause. First time we have made it to the nationals in the English Olympiad. She bagged the 16th rank. Congratulations. And Jagadarishno of 5th B secured 45th national rank in the English Olympiad. Jagadarishno also bagged a state rank in the Science Olympiad also. Next I call upon Shiva Manoj Rangareddy of 5th class who went for the nationals in kickboxing in the under 15 category. He is receiving the YPR Excellence Award for the remarkable achievement. And now we go with the YPR Scholarship Cash Awards. So the zeal of serving the underprivileged students, Mr. Pradeep is also extending the scholarships